I want to tell you, my brother, that today the Lord has given us a topic. It is Operation Demolition. We want to destroy all the devil. We want to destroy all the strongholds of Satan, whichever area of your life, every unconquered area of your life, every unconquered area of your family, every unconquered area of your son and daughter, every unconquered area of your life in general. God is going to conquer them on your behalf, and you will have testimonies in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to plead with you when it is the time to pray. When it is the hour of Jacob, when we come to Jacob's hour, and I leave you to talk to God in prayer. It is not a prayer you pray for 5 minutes and you keep quiet and you can't pray anymore. This day, today, this afternoon or morning, whichever way it is in your area, we have come to settle scores. We have come to finalize everything. This is Jacob's hour. You know what Jacob's hour is all about? I will not let you go except you bless me. I will not let you go except you touch me. I will not let you go except you change my story. And that is why I am telling you, when it is time to pray, when it is time to call upon God, I'm going to leave you to bombard heaven. I'm going to leave you to talk to your maker. I'm going to leave you to talk to your creator. I'm going to leave you to talk to the Lord. And I'm telling you, before you finish today's prayer, before you finish today's prayer, before you say the final amen, before you say the final amen, answer will come for you in Jesus' name. Let's close our eyes as we talk to the Lord. Our Father and our God, we thank you. We bless your name for this time. We give you praise. We give you glory. We thank you, Father, because you are the God that answers prayers. We want to thank you, Father, for all of the pastors who are here with us to bombard heaven with us, to call upon God, to lift up holy hands on behalf of your people. Father, we want to thank you. We want to bless your name, Father, for the salvation of our souls. Thank you, Father, because you gave us redemption. You gave us salvation. You gave us eternal life. You gave us the hope of heaven. You gave us the privilege of sonship. You gave us the privilege to use the name of Jesus. The privilege to call upon the name of Jesus. And so, Lord, we want to thank you. We want to bless you. Even before we start to pray, thank you, Father, because answers have come. Thank you, Father, because answers have come. Thank you, Father, because we are victorious already. Thank you, Father, because we are more than conquerors. Thank you, Father, because the miracle has started. Thank you, Father, because Satan has been defeated. Thank you, Father, because the bigger structure has been pulled down. Thank you, Father, for everything, oh God. Accept our plans and our praises in Jesus' name. Father, as we continue with us. Thank you, Father, because our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
We are going to take our text. Our text is taken from the book of Numbers. Numbers chapter 33. Numbers 33 verse 52. Let's see what the Bible says in the book of Numbers. Numbers chapter 33. We want to read verse 52. The Bible says, then ye shall drive out ye, you, me. He said, then ye shall drive out. God has given us a command. He did not say we should negotiate with anybody. He did not say we should negotiate with the devil. He did not say we should negotiate with powers of darkness. He didn't say we should negotiate with the giants of the land. He did not say we should negotiate with the sons of Anarchy. He said, then you shall drive out. The command is to drive them out. Drive out all, not some of them, not one, not two, not 10, not 50, not 100. He said you will drive out all the inhabitants. All the inhabitants of the land. Let me tell you, who are the inhabitants of the land? These are the unlawful occupants. They come to your house, They come to your family. They come to take build a house before you. They build a temple before you. They build their structure in your house. They build their structure in your family. Sometimes they may build that structure, that building, in your son and in your daughter. And those buildings, they represent something. But God told us, He said, "Then ye shall drive out the inhabitants of the land from before you." He said, when you drive them out, when you chase them out, when you send them away, what then do you do? He said, and destroy all their pictures. All the pictures of the enemy in your house. The picture of sickness. The picture of affliction. The picture of evil. The picture of Satan. The picture of sicknesses, or incurable sicknesses, terminal diseases, the picture of marital failure, the picture of separation, or the picture, wherever they took the picture to whatever, the Bible tells us, He said, we destroy all their pictures. And that's what we came to do. We came here to destroy all the pictures of the enemy. He said another thing, He said, and destroy all their molten images, all the image of Satan. The image of darkness, the representation of darkness. You see them in your dream. You see them physically. Something is touching your head and you are feeling it. Something is walking around your body. It travels from your head and to your toes. And something is doing one thing or the other in your life. And you can recognize them. And you can see them. And you can feel them. You touch your body, you see that in there. You touch your head, you see that in there. You touch your bone, you see that in there. You touch your skin, you see that in there. God said, destroy all their molten images. All the places, designated places, where they have stationed their images. Whether in your house, whether in your compound, whether under the tree, whether under the mango tree, the banana tree, the iroko tree, whatever tree it is, under whichever tree they have put that thing, we are going to destroy them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Bible tells us another thing. He said, and quite pluck down. That pluck down there, it means demolish. It means bring down. It means wreck. It means smash. It means ruin. It means destroy. He said, and thou shalt quite pluck down all their high places. All their high places. All the high places of darkness. The high places of wickedness. Wickedness in the highest order. All the building. You know, there's a song we always sing. We always sing in the Yoruba form. We say, Eshuole kole ti Jesu. Today we come to destroy, we come to pull down all the illegal structure of Satan in your life and in your family. And that's what we come to do. Today we are looking at Operation Demolition. Operation Demolition. When we say an operation is an action that is functioning. An operation is a fact of being active. When we say something is in operation, it means it is in effect. It is working. When we say demolition, demolition means to destroy. It means to ruin a building or other structure, especially on purpose. It means to destroy that building intentionally. It means to destroy it purposefully. It means to tear down. This afternoon, we come to tear down. To tear down the synagogue of Satan. To tear down the kingdom of darkness, tear down the kingdom of sin, to tear down the kingdom of oppression, to tear down the kingdom of sin, to tear down the kingdom of darkness in your life. It means to raise, it means to put an end to something. When we demolish, what does it mean? It means to explode.
That will not be seen again.
God has given us a standing order. From our text, God has given us a command. From our text, God has given us an instruction. And we must carry out the instruction of God. What is the instruction of God? He said, pull down strongholds. What is the instruction of God? Tear down illegal structures. What is the command of God? The instruction of God? Knock down the hand of Satan. where the hand of the devil is working in your life, we come to knock them down. Today we want to bulldoze. Have you seen a bulldozer pulling down a house? The bulldozer will not mind whether that house is big or not. His own is to wreck it down. Today we come to heal. We come to pulverize. We come to level. We come to dismantle. We come to obliterate. We come to wreck. We come to hammer. You see?
Amen.
What I want to do today, I'm going to put in your hand the armor of faith. With the armor of God in your heart, the sledgehammer, of God, you will knock down any wall. You will knock down any mountain. Break them down. Sickness that is representing your life and family, that sickness that will not go, that paralysis, that whatever standing order, anything the devil has deposited in your body, anything that is long standing, anything that is evil cycle, it came from your grandfather to you and to your children. You're going to bring him down with a sledgehammer. Today we come to massacre. Listen to me.
Yes.
I am not going to make any apology. Today, this afternoon or morning, whichever way it is in your location, today I come to tell you, my brother, if you are a child of God, we are going to commit what we call spiritual murder. We are going to murder the devil even today. We are going to destroy all the things that have been rooting or rising up in your life. We come to kill them. We come to massacre. We come to murder.
Yes.
That's why I want to tell you, it's no apology that is made to the devil today. We are not making apology with the devil. We are not making any negotiation with the devil. Today we come to commit what we call spiritual murder. You are going to destroy, you are going to kill, you are going to massacre, you are going to neutralize, you are going to shatter all the strong man and woman standing on your way. What do we come to do today? We want to
count
the enemy. I'm going to put your hand in a pestle. You will grind the devil like the way you pound jam. You will pound the devil.
Amen.
They are going to attack.
Amen.
We are going to trash all the works of darkness today. We are going to trash them. We are going to block them out. We are going to trash them. There is going to be a spiritual explosion. Explosion in the top of the
enemy. Amen.
Explosion in the brotherhood of the wicked. Explosion.
Amen.
Explosion over your life and family. We are going to crush them today. We are going to overturn them today. We are going to scatter them today. We are going to scatter them today. Whatever the enemy has done in your life, came here to undo it. Whatever the enemy has done, they are going to squash
it. Amen.
Wherever you are there on the platform, I want you to go before the Lord in prayer. Number one, we are going to what we call the hour of cleansing. Hour of cleansing. The blood of Jesus is flowing. Whatever we hinder your prayer from being answered, you want to talk to the Lord. Oh God, cleanse me. Oh God, wash me. Oh God, purify me. Open your mouth and call upon God. Open your mouth and call upon God. Open your mouth and call upon God.
My Father and my God, this thing in my life that have done, in the name of my prayers from being answered to my Father and my God, the one that loves me, the one that takes me as a son. I am praying and asking you, God, that you cleanse me in the blood of Jesus. I make me accessible to you. Cleanse me, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. name of Jesus Christ. Help me, O God, in the name of Jesus. We hear your prayer from me, Pastor. Wash me totally in the name of Jesus. Help me, O God. I need your touch. That one touch that will free me of every sin that we stand and need to answer prayer. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, my Father. I need your touch, O God. Wash me with the blood. Blood of Jesus. Wash me. Wash me, O God. Wash me with the blood. Wash me with the blood. Free me from every hindrance to answer prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ. With the washing of the blood. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen.
Bless you. Let the blood of Jesus purify you. Open your mouth and pray.
In the name of Jesus. Open
your mouth and pray.
Father, I need your touch. Wash me in the blood. Wash me. Wash me. Have forgiveness unto everything that would have stood as hindrance to my answer. In the name of Jesus Christ, wash me with the blood of the Lamb. The blood of my Lord Jesus Christ, my Father and my God, that simply blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary, the blood that was shed without sin on the cross of Calvary, for my renewal, O God, use it to wash me, wash me, wash away every stain from me, and take away every hindrance to answer prayer. This very day, I must receive answers. I must receive a turnaround. I must receive a writing of story. My history will change in the name of Jesus Christ. My family history will change today in the name of Jesus Christ. Watch me, O God. Watch me, O God. Everything that has hit us to hit us. Jesus, thank you, Father, for the answer prayer. In Jesus' mighty name, I
pray.
Jesus, wash me,
your
blood of
the water.
Make yourself accessible to me through the washing of the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Help me, O God. I know with you, all things are possible. If you increase me, you'll be well with me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, I pray. Do it, O God. I take all the glory to the Holy Spirit. I need your touch. I need your cleansing power. I need your washing, O God, with the blood of my Lord Jesus Christ. Use it to wash me from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. Wash me inside and outside. Wash me and make me useful in your hands. Accessible to you, O my Father, let nothing be in me that will hinder your presence in me, that will hinder your touch, O God. O my Father, wash me, that at any time you want to touch me, nothing will stand against my touch, nothing will touch against me. In the name of Jesus Christ, wash me, God. I need your touch, O my Father. I need your cleansing power. In the Cleanse me up, O God. Wash me, O God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, my Father. Lord Jesus. Wash me. In the name of Jesus. Wash me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Bless everybody. Of your blessing at any time. Cleanse me up from within and without. In the name of Jesus Christ, with the powerful blood of Jesus, the cleansing power in the blood of Jesus, use it to wash me, O God. In the name of Jesus, prepare me, ready for the music, ready for answer prayer, ready for writing of stories, ready for a transformation of life in every area, taking away every sickness, every interest, every attack of the enemy, destroying every tentacle of the wicked ones against me, every opposition of God, as you wash me, make me. Amen.
Amen.
Let your amen terrify the devil. Louder, amen.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. As we are about to start to pray now, please don't pity the devil. Don't pity your problem. Don't pity Satan. Satan does not pity you. That is why he attacks you and sends fire arrows at you. Now that you have the privilege of dealing with the devil, demolishing all his kingdom and building and in your life, please don't pity him. I want you to pray very well and cry upon the Lord. You are going to call upon the name of the Lord. I want you to say this loud and clear. You are going to pray. Every altar built in my life and family, I bring you down in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth.
I shatter them.
you travel, you will never shine anymore in my life from the very day. In the mighty name of Jesus.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Ah, let me tell you something. I've been praying on the platform. Today is exceptional. And my prayer from my heart is that after today's prayer, you will testify.
Yes. In the name of Jesus.
We are going to call upon the name of the Lord. I love the way you are praying. And in fact, my heart is so glad. But I want to tell you something before we pray. I told you when in the introduction that today we are going to commit what we call spiritual murder. Any hand that is troubling your life, any man that is troubling your life, any woman troubling your life, anyone from the village, any power from anywhere, any power from the sky, any power from the water, any power from the tree, anyone after the order of Jeroboam, Any hand that is stretched forth at you to do you evil, you are going to call upon the name of the Lord. Every strong man from anywhere troubling my life and family, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth,
I'm going to go to the hospital. Let them burn by fire.
I pray for you, my brother, my sister. Any hand that is drawing you back when you want to make progress, I command that hand to be cut off in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want to specifically pray all those who are looking up for children, to God for children, between now and October,
Jesus.
You will carry babies in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Let's listen. Because of our time, I have so much that we want to pray about, but time is really going. I'm just going to round everything off somehow. If you have testimony, prayer requests, you want to raise a prayer request, we are going to do something now. We are going to the last session that I call the Hour of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
If you are yet to receive baptism in the Holy Ghost, something is going to rest upon you now. Just release yourself, because God is going to do it. The way God is leading us on this platform, I'm telling you, God is taking us to the next realm. And so, without wasting time, anybody with prayer requests, where is the first prayer request? Raise it, and we pray together.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Do you want me to pray for my nephew that left the home? We don't know where he is. Let God bring him home back. Let him bring him home. Wheresoever it may be, the Holy Spirit arrest him to bring him home. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Next prayer request. The next.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I want the children of God to pray for healing. Perfect healing for me and my mother, and for my only daughter to get the God-ordained husband soonest, and for my other children to have financial freedom, genuine encounter with Jesus Christ all their lifetime in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Father, please. Any other request? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Divine healing for my mother who has been having challenges with her health. She has been having some mental challenges. So pray that visit and remove the cause of that problem in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Any other questions?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
To just want the children of God to lift me up. That the Lord will cancel every strange dream, evil pattern of foul dreams, evil dreams, in all these strange evil dreams, that the Lord God Almighty will destroy and cancel them and drive them out of my life by spirit power. Amen. Give me victory in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I will never let you go.
We are going to suffer the prayer is to God in prayer. You are going to call upon the name of the Lord. That thing that is in the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost, bring him out. Holy Ghost, find him out. Open your mouth and call upon the name of
Jesus. The hand of God,
I'm going to go to the hospital. I want you all to give you now very, very well, pray very well, for about 2-3 minutes. You are going to call upon the name of the Lord like this. We want to visit the foundation of your life and family. We want to visit that foundation. I'm telling you, we are going to pray. You foundation of my life. You foundation of my family.
I got you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let me tell you something, brethren. You may not see anything, but I see a lot here. Let me tell you something. By the grace of God, I see. Next week, by the grace of God, if Jesus delays that is coming, God is saying that next week, nobody will pray for you. Next week, if Jesus has not come, we are going to have a session I will be calling, I must tell Jesus. It is from the immediately we start this to the very end. It is alone with Jesus. You will tell God. I'm telling you, please invite many people next week. There is going to be instantaneous miracle. Something will be happening as you are praying. And next week, by the grace of the Lord, we are going to wait upon God. It is fasting and prayer next week. Next week, Saturday, the grace of God. So, it is waiting upon God. And next
week,
has answered.
You're the Son of God.
Pastor Matthew.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As I was with you, by the grace of the Lord, something is going on in my mind. That God, are you not going to answer the prayer of your people? See how they are pouring their mind. See how they are calling upon you. What do you want to be their testimony? And then, by the grace of the Lord, immediately, God took me to the book of Luke, chapter 19, verse 9. And Jesus said unto him, this day is salvation come to this house. My dear Father in the Lord, my dear mother in the Lord, my dear sister and my dear brother in the Lord, and colleague, I want you to know, today, just because everyone has put their mind down before God, and this is a challenge I want to bring to Almighty God. Yes, Zacchaeus made restitution before that message came. But I want to assure you, no matter what is in your cupboard, as far you have repented this morning, do not bother about Zacchaeus, that Zacchaeus made restitution before that message came. Do not bother about Zacchaeus, that there was repentance before that message came. Do not bother about that. The mind of Satan was fully open to honor Jesus Christ in his name before that message came. What you need to bother about is the death of Jesus Christ. By then, Jesus Christ have not died. But now, Jesus Christ has died, and that has redeemed you. And as a result of that, all the prayer you have answered, you have prayed upon the Lord today. The Father, I don't want to repeat this prayer again.
Amen.
Listen to what I said. That God, you are my God. Even if I go to 30 priests, and I do all what I've done within this 1 hour, that man will have mercy. And that's the mark you are created. Yeah. What about you that you have created me? As you answer Zacchaeus on that day, that salvation enter his house. Today, Almighty Father, I must not repeat that prayer again in my life. Open your heart, open your mouth, call upon the name of the Lord. That today, by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, it was instant. Yes, Jesus Christ entered the house of Zacchaeus. And then the Bible let us know, salvation has come. Salvation has come to that body in the name of Jesus Christ. That day, salvation has come to it in the name of Jesus Christ. That open mind won that by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, salvation has come out to it in the name of Jesus Christ. Imagine, even if I come to your house and I'm begging for money for all of that 1 hour, my dear brother, are you going to fold your hand? Will you not do something? Will you not say, Pastor Matthew, all that I don't have this, I don't have, but this what I have, I will use it to do. Look at that, what man did to Peter. Peter said, God or silver I have more. That is just Peter. What about Jesus Christ? That we have been calling upon us, it's almost 1 hour now. As the Bible said, today, he said, today, salvation come into your house. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, for all what we have requested for, by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, salvation come out to them today in the name of Jesus Christ. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon has come out to them. It was on that day, and Jesus Christ has not gone back to heaven. The prayer has not been there. The death has not been there. He has come, he has not been beaten. But now, he said on the Calvary, he said it is finished. He said it is finished. He said it is finished. That was my dear brother. That Lord, that you are crying for, by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. Bible, let me tell you, today salvation enter your house. My dear father in the Lord, that thing you are bothering about your mom and your friend. The Bible let me know that today, salvation enter into your house. My dear father in the Lord, that thing you are bothering about the sickness of your mom and the individual. The Bible let me know, today, salvation has come into your house. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, accept Jesus Christ, accept it. And by the power in the blood of Jesus, that salvation has come. That salvation has come. In your infirmity, in your poverty, in your barrenness, in your spiritual death, in your spiritual weakness, in your pain, in your sickness, upon your family, upon your wife, upon your husband, upon your children. Listen to what Bible says. He said today, salvation has come to your house by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. As God has Jesus Christ, entered the life of Zacchaeus on that day, today, just because of the death of Calvary, salvation enter your house today in the name of Jesus Christ. He entered that request in the name of Jesus Christ. He entered that all that he be in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Pastor Mike, please write down for us. We shall meet Pastor Prayer tomorrow, but it will be testimony by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Write down for us, Pastor Mike.
Let's pray. our Father and our God, the God that answers prayer.
Lord,
you have looked from heaven and you have seen how we have tarried before you in prayers. You said in your word that those who seek you will find you.
Amen.
We have sought your face, and it is a must, according to your word, for us to find you. Father, I pray that in the name of Jesus, every one of us on this platform who have prayed today, and we have cried unto the Lord, and we have poured our hearts unto you, those who are not able to join, but their minds are here, and they are praying, Father, silently, quietly over there, and those who have sent their request, who have sent their prayer request, Lord, you are the one who knows their desire. We pray in the name of Jesus, both them and ourselves. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, as our pastor has said, that when we gather tomorrow, it will be testimony galore. Father, let it be so in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our Father and our God, all the prayer requests that have been raised, Father, you are the one that knows the intent of those prayers, those requests. And so, Lord, I am praying and I'm asking, one by one, one after the other, both brothers and sisters, and our mommies and daddies, grandpa, grandma, oh Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, heal the sick, let that boy be found, let you sick. Because the Bible says by your stripes we are healed. Oh, there be a change, a positive change, your health. Oh God, where pain is in the body. I command you, hear the strangers we hear our you in the come out from your hiding, from that blood. Mighty God, I am praying and I'm asking that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, everyone present on this platform, we have a testimony.
Amen.
We have a testimony. Brother,
amen.
We have a testimony.
Amen.
My
brother,
we have a testimony.
Amen.
My brother,
amen.
Man, that Jesus Christ will rest upon you. You will not
amen.
Be weak. You will not be bedridden. Drunk. You will be agile. Amen. Doing for God in the name of Jesus. I pray that heaven, you will not miss it. I will not miss
every
one of us. We meet at last in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank
I cover you with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray that the glory of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost will rest upon you.
Amen.
I pray that your joy will be full.
Amen.
As our pastor, our daddy has prayed that this prayer, we will not repeat it. Father, let it be so in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for in our prayers.
Thank
in
you,
Jesus
Lord.
Name.
Thank you, God.
Amen. Amen. Let us build our faith by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Testimonies shall follow every one of us in Jesus' name. Remember
Amen.
The definition
Amen.
Of faith. And by the power
Amen.
And the blood of Jesus Christ, your faith will heal. Our faith will heal every one of us in Jesus' name. Thank you.
Amen.
God bless you all. We shall meet in pastor's prayer tomorrow. Thank you. I love you all.
The grace.
May the grace. Thank you. The love of God and the fellowship of Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall be with us all the days of our life.
I wish I do in the house.
I wish I do in the house.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.